In this segment, we're going to talk about the forward divided difference scheme or method for finding derivative of a function. And in this case, we're talking about continuous functions. So we want to use forward divided difference scheme for finding a derivative of a function. Now, let's go back, look at this graphically here. So let's suppose if I have a function like this, and this is what I want to find out the derivative of a function. So I got my function f of x here, and I got this as a function of x, and I want to find out what the derivative of the function here is. So basically what I'm trying to do is first derivative, trying to find the slope of the function at that particular point. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose a point which is delta x ahead. So that means that the distance between the two points which I have is delta x, between this point and this point. And the reason why I'm doing that is because I'm using my definition of f prime of x from a differential calculus class, which is the limit of delta x approaching 0, the value of the function at x plus delta x minus f of x divided by delta x. That's the definition of the derivative of a function which I learned from my differential calculus class. Now, what forward divided difference does is that it chooses a point ahead, but it cannot use delta x approaching 0, because if you're going to choose delta x approaching 0, you can always choose a smaller delta x. So what you're doing in the forward divided difference scheme is that you're going to take the same definition which you learned in your differential calculus class and say that, hey, f prime of x, I'm going to define approximately. I'm going to define my f prime of x approximately by this. It's the same thing without the limit. So what that means is that once you take the limit out, that you are choosing delta x to be a finite number, as opposed to choosing delta x approaching 0. And that's the formula for the forward divided difference scheme. So I call it FDD. FDD standing for F for forward, D for divided, and D for difference. So that's the FDD formula for the derivative of a function. So you can very well see right there you're going to get truncation error, because your delta x is a finite number as opposed to delta x approaching 0. You are approximating a mathematical procedure by this particular formula. Let's go and see through an example how good we get as the numbers for calculating the approximate value of this derivative here. So I've chosen a simple function like f of x equal to 2 e to the power 1.5x. And somebody's telling me, hey, go ahead and calculate f prime at 3. Find out the derivative of this function at x equal to 3. And what I'm being asked to do is that I'll have to, if you look at the formula which I just showed, so let me write down it again. F prime of x is approximately equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x divided by delta x. And I already know that what x is, because x is 3. Somebody's telling me to calculate the value of the function, derivative of the function at 3. But I don't know what delta x is. And that's something, I suppose, is either given to me or I choose it of my own accord. So let me choose delta x equal to 0.1. So I'm going to choose delta x equal to 0.1. So let's go and see that what kind of a derivative of function I get. It's f prime of 3 will be approximately equal to the value of the function. X is 3, delta x is 0.1, the value of the function x is 3 divided by delta x, which is 0.1. So all these values are known to us. X is 3, delta x is 0.1, so that's what we need to do. And this becomes the value of the function at 3.1 minus the value of the function at 3 divided by 0.1. So if you just look at this particular expression carefully, all you're doing is calculating the value of the function at 3.1, calculating the value of the function at 3, and dividing by 0.1. So which is basically is the value of the function at these two points and the difference between the arguments of those two function values. The argument here is 3.1 and the argument here is 3. So what is the difference? 0.1, and that's what goes in the denominator. So it's rise over run. That's about it. This is the rise of the function going from 3 to 3.1, and this is the run going from 3 to 3.1. Because what is this? This is nothing but 3.1 minus 3. So if you want to write it in a different way, that's what it is, 3.1 minus 3, rise over run. So all I have to do is now to calculate the value of the function at 3.1, which is 2 to the power 1.5, 3.1, minus 2 e to the power 1.5 times 3, divided by 0.1. And this value here turns out to be equal to 291.35. So that's what I get as the approximate value of the derivative of the function at 3, 291.35. In order to be able to see that how good this method of forward divide difference is working, let's go ahead and calculate the exact value from our differential calculus knowledge and then see how what kind of true errors we are getting. So if you look at the function f of x, which we have, which is 2 e to the power 1.5x, the f prime of x will be nothing but 2 times 1.5 e to the power 1.5x. This comes from the formula that the derivative of e to the power ax is nothing but a e to the power ax. That's where that derivative comes from a differential calculus class. So I get 3 e to the power 1.5x. I was interested in calculating the value of the function, derivative of the function at x equal to 3. So I'm going to get 3 e to the power 1.5. X is 3. And this number here turns out to be exactly equal to 270.05. So that's the exact value of the derivative of the function at 3. 270.05, of course, it's only up to 5 significant digits. There are more digits there. But that's what the exact value is up to 5 significant digits for f prime of 3. And you can see that there is a difference. So what I got for f prime of 3, I got approximately it equal to 291.35. This was with delta x equal to 0.1 using the forward divide difference scheme. And f prime of 3, exact value is 270.05 for delta x approaching 0. That's from the definition of the derivative of a function from your differential calculus class. So in this case, the true error is the true value minus approximate value. True value is 270.05, and approximate value is 291.35. And the difference between the two is minus 21.30. So that's what you're getting as the true error for what you obtain by using delta x equal to 0.1 and what you obtain exactly. So I'm going to draw a table. What I did was I said, okay, now we're getting a true error of 21.30, which is equivalent of 7.88% as your relative, absolute relative true error.